Joannis in Seattle, Washington, listening on the Catholic Answers Live app. Joannis, you are on with Tim Staples.
Hello, Tim. I've heard so much from you. You are one of the great apologists my Catholic friends recommend to, aside from Scott Hahn. And I'm so privileged to be able to talk to you.
Well, I'm privileged to talk to you, my friend. What's on your mind?
So, Tim.
Yes.
I am now on my way to full communion with a Catholic church.
Praise God, brother.
And I will be received on Divine Mercy Sunday. Praise the Lord.
Beautiful. Praise God.
However, a few days earlier, I got into a debate with a fundamentalist Protestant minister.
Yes.
Who questioned about the Eucharist.
Yes.
Now, I was able to answer a lot of his questions regarding the Eucharist, regarding faith and works, and even regarding biblical canon, which many of my cradle Catholic friends are still uninformed about.
Yes.
However, this Protestant fundamentalist asked a certain question, which I'm still looking for a good answer to.
Okay.
He says, if the bread and the wine really becomes the blood and body of Jesus, of Christ, then what about the first Eucharist? Because in the first Eucharist, Jesus was still fully human, fully well. He wasn't yet crucified. Blood hasn't yet poured out of his body.
Yes.
But when he broke the bread and poured the wine, we believe that it is his real blood and body.
Yes, it
was. How could we reconcile the first Eucharist with the fact that Jesus was still full and well?
Yes, great question, my friend. And remember, yes, he was fully human then, but he's still fully human, right? As 1 Timothy 2:5 says, there is presently one God and one mediator between God and man, the man Jesus Christ. He is still fully God and fully man. Just want to make that very clear. But understand, and your friend needs to understand, that God is outside of time. To God, there is an absolute now. All things are absolutely now. He can easily, because he's all-powerful, he can easily apply the merits of what Jesus Christ did in any way he sees fit. He can go back before the actual crucifixion and apply what Christ did on the cross because of the fact that he is all-powerful. And that's one thing, my friend, that all of us agree as Christians. All Christians believe that God is almighty. So there's nothing logically contradictory in saying that God can apply what Christ did on the cross into the future as well as into the past, because there is no future and there is no past with God. All things are now. Does that help?
Yeah, that's one of the answers I got. But what if, he keeps on challenging, what if the Protestant fundamentalist keeps on asking, yes, but please show me transubstantiation in the Bible.
Sure.
Did Jesus say anything about it?
Sure, absolutely. Now, not the word. I think what you want to do is point out to them, hopefully these are Christians, if they're Protestant fundamentalists, the word Trinity isn't in the Bible either. But the reality of the Trinity is, in the same way, the word transubstantiation is not there. However, the reality is, Jesus took bread and wine and said, this is my body, this is the chalice in my blood, transforming them. Because as I said earlier, God's word is more powerful. Jesus' word is more powerful than nature. When he says it, that's what it becomes. And that's what St. Paul teaches it is in 1 Corinthians 10:15-17 and 1 Corinthians 11:27-29.